Hello beautiful people and welcome to another video. Where do I begin with this one? I found this in an old garden shed and someone used it to store soil, old flower pots and all sorts of things. The shed was overgrown by trees and bushes and took a long time to get this out. It was covered in dirt and spiders and we had to wear gloves to even touch it. It was absolutely disgusting, swollen, just really wet and dirty. And I didn't even know if I could do anything with it. The person who gave this to me said that whatever was inside was mine because we couldn't get it to open. It was just so wet and swollen. That is proper retro. I kind of like it. So this hinge was actually completely hidden and I couldn't figure out how to get the doors out, but I just flipped it upside down and eventually found a little thing that I had to unscrew and I was able to remove them. Whoever painted this didn't do a very good job and definitely didn't prime, because some of the paint came off super easily and some didn't. And just to show you that there was no lead, because I know that some of you are going to say it, there's the test and this paint was lead free. This was probably the most scraping I've ever done on a piece of furniture. But I wanted to save the veneer if possible, and I didn't want to risk going through it with a sander. So that took a long time. And if you guys like this sort of thing, I'll be doing a collaboration video with Anders from Mid-Century Flipper. He works on mostly mid-century modern furniture and does a lot of scraping. So that's gonna be a fun challenge, and I'll post the link in the description and I'll put it in the end screen so you can check him out and say hello from me. As I said, I tried paint stripper on bits of this credenza or buffet or whatever you want to call it, just because it was easier, at least that's what I thought, than scraping. And it did okay, but scraping was the way to go. And here's a satisfying time lapse of paint stripper at work. As you can see, it worked and was slightly disgusting, just as you guys like it, so you're welcome. I basically removed as much as I could and I just used my scraper to finish it off. How's this for a satisfying paint removal? I think maybe they just didn't clean this piece before they painted it, or maybe there was wax on it or something, but from the doors the paint just came off. I could literally just peel it off with my fingers. That's how easy it was. Not as much on the legs, unfortunately. The legs were also quite badly damaged. and I had to repair and re-glue them. And I thought that the best and the easiest way to remove the paint on the curved surfaces was to use my sandblaster. And when I was done with sandblasting, I did some more scraping. And then a little more.
Two thousand years later.
Wow, that took forever, and I think the friendly neighborhood cats could tell that I needed an emergency cat break, so they teamed up to cheer me up a little bit, and it definitely helped. To take a short break from scraping, I decided to do my second favorite thing, which is sanding.
A few moments later.
I think this summarizes this whole project quite well, if you know what I mean. So it looks like the hinges are actually attached from the bottom, which I could see once I took the legs off, and that actually helped a lot that I could take the doors off, because it just made everything a little easier. And normally I try to avoid taking screws out of MDF boards, because sometimes you can't really screw them back in because MDF is very soft, but in this case it actually made a big difference and it helped a lot. I also sanded the bottom, the back and everything else as I always do. This project took way over a week, and there were many small repairs that I had to make, and I didn't record all of it because there were just too many of them. Small pieces of veneer or bits that I had to fill with wood filler and things like that, color correction, and yeah, lots of little things. But just to give you an idea that there's just way more to it than you can see in the video. After removing the varnish and sanding, there were many patches of different shade of color and some stains, and I just, you know, wasn't happy with it, so I tried oxalic acid, hoping that it would bleach it a little bit, and it did, not completely, but it made a difference. I applied two coats, and when everything was dry, I rinsed it with water, which you have to do to deactivate it and to clean it. As you can see, it's looking much better, but not good enough to keep it as it is, because if I applied some sort of oil, it would only make the stains more visible. So I use hydrogen peroxide, hoping that that would help a little bit. It works kind of like oxalic acid. It bleaches wood and potentially removes stains. And it did help, but didn't remove the stains completely. As you can see, there is a little bit of exposed MDF from the doors rubbing against the veneer, but I'm just going to use touch-up markers to blend it in, because otherwise it would be quite difficult to repair this. As always, huge thank you to all of you generous and wonderful people for supporting the channel, helping to keep the lights on at the shop, and using my Amazon wishlist link, buying me coffees via Buy Me Coffee, or hitting the Super Thanks button. That makes a huge difference, helps to keep the lights on at the shop, and pays for the cat snacks. Thank you, and special thanks to all the wonderful channel members. You guys are the best. I guess many people would be happy with it at this point, but I wasn't, so I knew I would have to do something with it. But anyhow, I moved on to the drawers, I sanded them, cleaned them. One of them had this felt thingy for cutlery, so I removed the bottom to make it easier for myself to sand it off. And yes, it pained me to work in such a messy environment, but I was almost done for the day and I just wanted to rush through it, so I cleaned it up afterwards. But this is what the drawer looked like when I was done with it. I use 180 grit sandpaper to take off most of the varnish from the doors, and I did the rest of it by hand, all the edges, just to make sure I didn't burn through the veneer. I cleaned the hinge with a wire brush, again because this is MDF, I didn't want to remove it, just because sometimes the screws have nothing to grab onto when you put it back, so this was just easier. And then I repeated the process with oxalic acid and hydrogen peroxide for all the other parts of the buffet. These handles were attached with nails that were inside the handle, and it was very difficult to get them out, so I just left the handles in and I cleaned them up with a wire brush and I polished them, and they cleaned up very nicely. There was a little bit of rust on the inside, so I just used a small wire brush to clean it off. And right here you can see me sanding off wood filler that I applied off camera. There were two small gaps where veneer was missing, and this was just the best way to repair it. As I was waiting for the oxalic acid to dry, one of the friendly neighborhood cats stopped by to give me a quick cuddle. And now onto the pull-out thingies that were on the side of the buffer. I don't know what you would call these. I cleaned them with white spirit, and I didn't know what to do about the formica because it was in a perfect condition but just didn't look right, at least with the color scheme that I had in mind. So I cleaned the best I could the inside of these drawer pull-out thingies, and I used Restore Refinish just to rejuvenate them a little bit because the insides were in good condition. They just were not used a lot. And the brass element, I just cleaned it up and I polished it with the little brush thingy. The other pull-out thing had those rails, and I thought they were brass just like the element on the other side, but they were not. So I tried to polish them, but the paint came off, so I decided to paint them brass color. And as I mentioned before, I used Restore Finish on the inside and it did the job. As far as the formica top, I decided to paint it black. There were going to be some black elements in my design, so I thought it would go very well with the rest of it. The legs were the worst out of this whole buffer. There were little bits of rot and lots of rust. I had to re-glue parts of it and took a long time to sand it and clean it up. Obviously, because this wood was very old and discolored, I was not able to clean it up to uniform nice color, but it looked all right. I used my new sander that I got from Cards & Millie. This is a small business in Australia. It's run by a friend of mine, and this is basically the same thing as Surf Prep, but much cheaper. So if you guys are interested, I'll put a link in the description. I think it cost me about 60% of what I would have paid for the Surf Prep, and that includes the customs fee and shipping. The round element on this leg needed some repairs, so I used this fancy contraption to clamp it together and glue it, and this bit needed re-gluing as well, so I did that and I clamped it together and left it to dry. Use my dental tools to pick out all the bits of paint that were stuck in difficult to reach places until I was satisfied. And I moved on to repairing veneer bits that were missing, and I pull out my stash of veneer edge bending and just old bits of veneer that I saved from other projects, and I reapply the edge bending along this whole edge because it was not looking great. I trimmed off the excess veneer and I used a sanding sponge to clean up the edges. And I was finally ready to stain. I decided to go with plum mahogany, which is a very nice, rich, warm brown color with a hint of plum. The name is a bit confusing because you think it's a bit purple. And it does look purple when you first apply it, but it's not, trust me. All the sanding and bleaching and scraping paid off because the stain went on perfectly smooth and even, and I was very happy with it. I repeated the process on the doors and the side pull-out thingies, and again everything looked very nice and I was very pleased. And the brass against this plum mahogany color was really, really nice. You can see as I'm applying the stain to the legs that the wood is just soaking everything in because it's so dry and old, so I was not able to apply the stain the same way I did to the rest of it, so the legs are a bit darker, but that's fine. I was not going to do this on the rest of the buffet, but because of the shape of the legs, it just made it so much easier to spray the finish on, so that's what I did. And for the rest of the buffet, I went with furniture oil, and this one is clear dead matte. This is super easy to work with and it's as simple to apply as you can see. You literally just rub it on. As you can see, I didn't stain the inside of the buffet because originally it was a different color. There is sapili, maybe mahogany, I can't really tell, veneer inside, and on the outside it's oak, so I kind of kept it the original way and I just applied the oil as well as to the inside and outside of each drawer, and that protected the wood and made it look nice. And this is my favorite time of each project. I cleaned up the hardware with a wire wheel and I put everything together. For the exposed bit of MDF that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I just used a touch-up marker to blend it in and I was happy with how it looked. And wow, what a journey this has been, and what a transformation. It's absolutely amazing, and I couldn't have imagined a better outcome. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have, give me a like and subscribe if you haven't already. And if you're feeling extra generous, you can hit the super thanks button, or you can buy me a coffee via Buy Me a Coffee. Check out the links in the description and enjoy the final results. See you in the next video.